Hello, my friends, and welcome back. It is Monday, August 12th, 2024. I'm the Drunk Poker Guru. Tis beer time. How you doing? How you been? Where you going? Center hydrangeas is coming along nicely. It's a big hydrangea. I like it. I like it a lot. It wasn't as big when I planted. It was just a little thing, and now it's this monster that grows to epic proportions every year. We're going to return to Steel Wheel Brewery. We had a beer from them last week that, to put it nicely, was not well-crafted. It was an unmitigated disaster. I have tried another sip of a different beer they had. It was not fantastic, not as bad as the Rye Pale. But then I thought, we've got more beers. Let's hope it was just a one-off. You know, we're going to do the wheat beer now, wheat ale, 5.5%. I believe they use Canadian wheat and their own Cascade hops, which I like. So it's an American-style wheat. You're going to feel more citrus, more, you know, more hops than, say, you're going to get that kind of wheat notes like when you drink a nice German wheat. I like the smell off the nose. That's good. I'm going to drink it out of my Hillbilly Hefner glass. I said that to one of the kids at work, and they have no idea who Hugh Hefner is. Which is kind of weird, but I mean, not really anymore. I guess times are different. I am getting some, like, banana-y bubblegum notes off that, but let's get into it. Cheers, my friends. Return. Give them a try. That's not bad. That's not bad. I wouldn't put this in the highest category, but it's much, much better than the Rye Pale Ale that they, or the Rye Ale that they had. This certainly leans into more of a wheat beer with an American spin on it, where you're getting a bit more bitterness. I'm definitely getting a bit of grapefruit coming in here. You're still getting some of that bubblegum and that clove coming through, which really in this style, you shouldn't get much of that, which is fine. You're going to get some no matter what, wheat beer, right? But you're getting some of that grapefruit pith. There's a little bit of spice, which Cascade brings to the fore. That's okay. It's okay. Compared to the other one, it's ridiculously fantastic, but compared to like any that I've had of the style, it's middling, right? Meh, as we call it. Problem with these are like $6 a bottle. Like, I got six beers, cost me $40, and I was like, that's pricey. Who's bottling anymore either? Really? Yeah, it's the nature of the beast, right? The size of your brewery, what you've got. You've got a bottler. That's what you're going to do in a small brewery, right? It's okay, a little undercarbed. And I feel that might be the cap, because you don't hear that when you crack that cap, and that always is a little worrying to me. This one's weird as it warms up a little bit too. Again, not terrible, but would I buy it again? No, I probably wouldn't go back to this brewery at this point now. That's three beers I've tried and three beers that have made me either go, or meh. And really at that point, why are you going back, right? There's 300 and something breweries in Ontario. Let it be somebody else's, because this was clearly somebody's favorite brewery, because when I put up the video, they got a little pissy about it, and I was like, okay, go watch somebody else, because I don't know who you think I am. I'm not a politician. I don't got to listen to this crap. Yeah, that's not great. Trying to be nice here. Trying to be positive. It's just, it's not even middle of the road, and I think that's part of the problem, right? It honestly, it does remind me a lot of homebrew. If this was your homebrew, I'd be like, oh, not a bad job there, homebrew guy. Yeah, but, you know, professional, it should be a little better. Anyways, that's my opinion. I'm sure everybody has their own. I know Joe does. Oh, Joe. Cheers, my friends. Enjoy your day. It's somehow getting worse the longer it goes on, and that's not a good sign, so I'm going to be like the what's his name? Simon Cowell, that's a no from me.